Hello, my name is
Brian. All right, so we made some gummy bears here, and she was not too happy about some of these choices. But we have drunk gummy bears.
Not just drunk gummy bears. There's soy sauce gummy bears.
They're drunk on everything. They just got into all kinds of stuff. So we're just gonna.
They've been bouncing here and there and everywhere. Anyways, if you hear any background noise, our little friend Chi-Chi the chinchilla over here is running on his wheel in the middle of our of our gummy bear trial. So we're gonna be trying these gummy bears.
Should I pull a random?
We should do it randomly. We're gonna be trying the gummy bears, and we're gonna be making pierogies while we're doing it because I have pierogi dough made up and leftover mashed potatoes. So we're gonna make up some pierogies.
Let's try.
And this is my palate cleanser because some are gonna be gross. And Brian,
look, it's refreshing.
I labeled all the cups, so Brian doesn't know what they say. This one just says Dr. McGillicuddy's. It's a menthol liqueur, but I always have to talk with a funny accent and be like, Dr. McGillicuddy, and have that exact accent every time.
Every time.
And these guys got pretty big in here, and they definitely leached some color into the doctor's drink.
Yeah. Oh.
I want to eat the clear soft one. Or should we?
There's supposed to be four. How is there only three?
Oh, those are giant. Okay. Did you have the other gummy bears to show the size difference?
No.
You should grab them. Get up and go grab them. There is four. One's down at the bottom.
Yeah, I saw that.
Well, it's because it's clear, Brian. It was a visual effect. Ooh, this smells very minty mentally. Okay. I'm gonna grab one for size comparison here. I don't have to put it on the fork.
Why not?
Whoop. Hold on. He's like, no! You mustn't. They're soft, they're slipping.
Sometimes slippery.
So he's probably four times.
Oh, yeah.
Four times his original size. Definitely.
If you leave these in here for like a week or two, they turn into jelly and you can just spread it on your toast.
Yeah, we accidentally forgot we made drunk gummy bears the one day, and next thing we know, we found it in the back of the refrigerator. All right, I'm going to try the clear one. I said we should have done one that soaked up water just to see out of randomness, but
we look like this, but no color loss.
But we didn't have any room in our box. We only had enough room for, how many flavors did we do?
22.
22 flavors. All right. It's so mushy and strong. Oh, Dr. McGillicuddy. And it stuck to my teeth.
That's refreshing.
No, I don't like it. I'm not gonna like, if I don't like this, I am not gonna like a lot of those.
Wow.
I feel like we should have something to rinse our forks off in between.
You don't think menthol with soy sauce is a good cross?
Maybe.
It's not bad.
It was strong. Do I have to eat the other one then?
I'm not gonna force it.
If I eat this one, do I get a veto and to not try one of the other cups?
I guess.
Two? Ugh. It wasn't better the second time.
You want to take the shot?
No.
I've never really cared for this as a shot.
Not if it tastes fruit. I think the problem is they're fruity.
Well, Andrea. We're watching Andrea.
That's our friend Andrea. Dr. McGillicuddy's is absolutely disgusting. It's an atrocity. It's an atrocity to alcoholic beverages.
Let's go for a non-alcoholic second one to kind of.
That's not non-alcoholic.
That's not no. Let's not do that. Not yet.
That's heading for the big stuff.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, you know what?
Okay, I did the center first.
Oh. Okay.
I went down when I filled the box.
That's okay. That's all out.
I told you. Coffee. What do you think that one is, Brian?
Coffee.
I did all my own artwork upon my labeling. This is just black coffee. We should have added some cream and sugar. Oh, what? Hold on.
What happened?
Hold on. I wish we had something to pour this into. I'm pretty sure they melted to the bottom.
Oh, well, it was hot.
I'm gonna make him get up like 15 times. Let's see.
It's all right. We're married.
It's one solid.
It's a gummy block.
Gummy bear in the bottom. Well, I guess that means I only gotta try a little piece then. Let me get the smallest piece that breaks off. It's better than Dr. McGilligutty. It's
a That's interesting.
The fruit flavor in the coffee is a little weird.
It feels wrong. There's something wrong with that.
I didn't think it tasted that bad.
Fruit and coffee do not go together.
I got you those raspberry coffees.
I don't know. It's something about it.
That one wasn't that bad.
I'm assuming this is apple.
Obviously, by my brilliant artwork. It's hard to draw on the side of a styrofoam cup.
And a...
You, giant. My friend, cannot have any. Mr. Miles.
No alcohol for you.
This is apple juice. Everybody's gonna think we're drunkards.
Yeah.
Okay, if I have apple juice, what flavor would go best? Lemon.
Lemon apple.
I like that one. It's just apple juice. You just had a green one.
Didn't really pick up the flavor.
It picked up a little.
Unless that was lime and I just... Not apple.
The juice picked up the flavor of the gummy bears. And the sugar. Ooh, that's sweet.
Not very sweet. But not very much flavor.
Do you need a fork cleanser? I just washed my apron. I was wiping off some of the weird flavors.
Let's do this.
This one's labeled.
Amaretto smells amazing.
Does it smell amazing now?
Yeah, still nice.
It does. Here.
Amaretto.
Our little friend back here on his wheel. I don't know what color to go with. So I'm going with yellow.
Not very soft.
That's what used to be yellow. The Dr. McGillicuddy's was getting stuck in my teeth. It's soft at first, and then when you get into it, there's really a hard part.
It's the gummy bear. It's the actual gummy bear.
I'm gonna need some more water. The kids' Easter baskets are over there. Maybe we need some Pringles for a palate cleanser. Would you do 10 times?
I said, I could just get up 10 times if you need some water.
I do have 13 more times to go. You're eating the second one? Wait, okay, so there's 22 flavors. If we each eat two of everything, that's 44 gummy bears. That's a heck of a lot of gummy bears. Okay, wait, okay. So I would eat in the yellow because I thought they were lemon, but there's also pineapple in here. Those are the clear ones. The green are strawberry.
Ooh.
The green ones are strawberry. They're not lime. The orange are obviously orange, and the red is raspberry. That I did not expect.
The orange or the vanilla.
I wonder what the... Rattle, rattle, rattle. Pineapple. Wait, is he holding a pineapple? His belly's all up.
Wait, is it a rabbit?
No, well, it's a bear.
Well, look, it looks like a rabbit.
And then right now, you're disgracing the Haribo company. Nope, the orange guy's got a belly just like it.
He's not holding a pineapple.
I have a funny...
It's Haribo. It's not
Haribo. Haribo. I have a funny story about gummy bears that you've heard before. About my gummy bear guy.
Oh, yeah.
Back when I worked in a call center, a friend and I, we'll pick another one while I tell our story. We worked overtime, so she just, and you can, when you work overtime, you can sit in any cubicle you want. So she sat, the cubicle next to me was taken, so she sat in the cubicle diagonal from me. While she's sitting there, the guy's desk she's sitting in, he had a little Hot Wheel car. And I had a pack of gummy bears. He had a Hot Wheel car like on the top of his desktop. And I thrown a gummy bear at her. So before we left, she put the gummy bear in the guy's Hot Wheel. And the next day, he didn't know who sat at his desk. I didn't know this. I'd never spoken to this person whatsoever. And he moved the gummy bear around, like almost put it like, I can't even remember exactly. Did something with it to make it almost like a scene. So, the next day, and this went on for weeks, I can't even remember what we did next. It started out small. Like, we put a second gummy bear. Then we put gummy bears, like, doing stuff around on his desk. And then got to the point where I was making elaborate scenes, spending days at home making elaborate scenes, and taking them into work and setting them up on his desk. This random person that we didn't even know, we called him GBG for Gummy Bear Guy. And there was a Christmas scene where there was a Christmas tree and tiny, tiny little gummy bear Christmas gifts. I think there was a scene maybe where it was a zoo. There was one where it was a disco dance party and I had a disco ball hanging from the ceiling of this little shoebox diorama that I had made. Like, this went on for weeks and weeks and weeks. He never had spoken to me before. I don't know this person. He sits diagonal from me and comes in after I do. So I see his reaction every single day. And I'm sitting there emailing and texting my friend. I was like, oh my God, he's blah, blah, blah right now. It was just such a hilarious story. Sorry. No, it was just too good. I gotta do something like that again someday because it was...
This is fruit punch.
Trust me, by the end of it, he was like, what the heck? Like, he had friends dead at his desk and everything. But yes, Fruit. Say it again. Say it like I did.
Like.
Fruit.
Oops.
Fruit. Fruit punch. I bet this probably tastes just fine.
Accent punch.
I didn't actually like the punch when we put it in there.
Actually, pretty good.
Tastes nice and fruity. While he's eating that next one, I have a bowl. Leftover mashed potatoes here. Normally I would make a potato that I didn't add milk or anything to for my pierogies, but it was just Easter. I have leftover mashed potatoes. And I have a Liam spying on me over there. So I'm just gonna pour these mashed potatoes in a bowl.
You gotta re-engineer them.
Yeah, I mean, they're a little thinner than I normally like for pierogies, but...
Thinner.
And then... Huh?
Thinner.
Oh, no! My caramelized onions turned into one solid mass. Liam, stick those in the microwave for me for a minute. Thanks, assistant! What did you say they have for dinner? Did you say something about dinner?
I said thicker.
Oh, yeah, because normally you want it so you can almost roll it into a ball.
That's pretty thick.
That's because they're cold, fresh out of the refrigerator! But we leave our peels on. It's got some salt and pepper.
Yeah, sure.
I am going to add a pretty significant amount of salt to the rest of these, because we want it to be that I don't have to add anything once the pierogies are cooked. That's how I like to measure stuff.
How do you like that?
It's still a solid. Nope, it's good. Anyways, I caramelized 3.5 onions the other day. yesterday. Very well caramelized with a stick of butter and a little bit of oil so the butter didn't burn. And see how nice and brown they are? They smelled so good when they got done caramelizing. But see, with this, this is gonna add liquid and it's gonna make it softer, even more so.
And time.
So I got some. Let's get rid of all my. Got a handy dandy little junk container right here. I'm trying to keep everything out of the way. But I'm just going to stir in my caramelized onions and all my salt and pepper. A lot of people put cheese in pierogies. It's like a big thing. I cannot taste the cheese when we put it in pierogies. We put like whole blocks of cheese. And when it comes down to it, you can't taste it. If you're gonna put, I'd rather fry them up and put cheese on my pierogi. Like sprinkle a little cheese on top.
Nothing wrong with that.
All right, Ryan, dip your fork in here and try my pierogi mixture. Make sure I didn't put too much salt in. If I did, I can't do anything about it.
Cold.
Oh, yeah. Brian, try my cold mashed potatoes. Hey, baby kitty.
It's good.
Good? All right, so I'm going to set this aside. We're going to get back to eating our drunkard gummy bears. Just for a moment. Oh, do you see what's going on with my label on that one? My label's drunk from the tequila. It's like, it's falling down the side.
This is your specialty right here.
I like tequila because it's got a lot of bang for its, you know, for its buck.
So that's vodka. That's my go-to. It's vodka.
I know, I don't like the taste of tequila. I'm going to go for 2 for 1.
Wow, that's a...
Wait, why don't you eat these and I'll just take the rest all in one shot?
All right.
I'll take the tequila and everything. And by the time we actually get to rolling out the pierogies, I'm going to be like... Terrible. Oh, God.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
I swallowed the gummy bear's whole. Get one, Liam can try.
What's that?
A nice,
what do you think,
simple,
Lynn?
Grape.
This is grape juice.
Yeah, nothing bad.
All right, Liam, come here.
Grapefruit juice.
I like it.
Not grapefruit, just grape.
Well, grape juice.
Not grapefruit. Those are two.
Well, okay, it's not. It's not those grape are two different fruit. Things.
This is grape. The part where.
Which is a fruit?
It's a fruit. It's a fruit juice. So it's a grapefruit juice.
I want to try the orange. I think the orange one will be good. Excuse me, Mr. Miles. Why are you on the table? Excuse me, my friend. Excuse me. Excuse me.
It's alcoholic.
Miles Zilla is in front of our shop.
Oh, Miles.
Liam, why don't you grab Miles?
Oh, you're so cute.
You said orange.
I said there is orange.
Here you go.
Triple
sec.
Three times the sex. S N S E C S.
Triple.
It sounded better when I wrote it. Which one are you least looking forward to trying? This one's got, you can't try this one.
Yeah.
I don't like that either. Oh. Yes. The flavor in my nose. Side. Oh, yeah.
It tastes like orange.
Huh?
Tastes like orange.
I'd have to disagree. So, my pierogi dough. I actually four times the sucker. The single recipe is super easy. It is, okay, well, I can give you my four times recipe here. I used 4 eggs, 8 cups of flour, 2 cups of sour cream, 2 sticks of softened real butter, can't replace it with margarine here, and 2 teaspoons of salt. And then it is super, super hard to get it all together and to knead it together until it's all the flour is combined. And then it's like an amazing magic trick because you put it in the refrigerator.
Super hard.
And you open it, and when you get it back out, because I usually go overnight, it is all glutenized and combined together to form this nice, I'm telling you.
Super hard dough.
Well, yeah, it's hard. But it's
super hard.
It's stretchy. Look how stretchy that is.
Cutting out perfectly.
If you would see, I've seen this when I was mixing it together with my hands, you wouldn't believe it was the same dough. Like, it was so dry. This one's got a sad look on his face. But now it's a nice, stretchy dough. And it won't quite give you the same results if you use margarine instead of butter. So I'm going to cut off a chunk. And while I'm not working with it, I definitely want to keep it covered because it will dry out. Hello, dear. Liam likes to make pierogies. And I did get, I normally just do it on the table, but because I usually actually use one of these cups to cut it. But I'm using a real metal cookie cutter today, and I don't want it cutting my table. Now, this has only been on the refrigerator for about half an hour. And Milezilla, Brian, is behind you, getting ready to jump on the table.
Milezilla.
Like Godzilla, but with a cat.
Miles.
I have had
Miles.
This rolling pin my entire life. I have no idea where it came from.
Where it came from?
No, the rolling pin, goofball. The dough came from all the ingredients.
Oh.
It's so hard.
I'm imagining how hard.
You know what I want?
I'm imagining how hard.
Oh, that's what she said, joke.
I'm imagining how hard it is in my brain right now.
It's very difficult. You want to try and roll it? Of course he does.
How do you?
See, That side always pops out. Apparently. All your strength, Liam.
Okay.
I feel like Dad's face is getting a little red.
From what?
I don't know. Too many gummy bears?
Corn.
I think Dad might have had too many gummy bears.
That's all I can do.
And that's funny.
Dr. McGillicuddy come back?
Apparently he did. Alright, this is not even actually half of the how thin we need to roll it. You need to roll it pretty damn thin. Like, you almost can feel like you almost think, oh god, I can almost see through that. It is really hard right now. I would say you're gonna leave this out, cover it wrapped in its plastic wrap for 45 minutes or so. What flavor is that, Brian?
Well, I feel like this is vodka. You're actually the one taking the shot.
Okay. Feel like that's all my bad. I'm not ready for it yet, Liam. It's still not thin enough.
Let it right there.
It's gonna go all over the place.
Are you thin enough to be my pierogi? Well, I put it back on the mat because. Okay. Let me just roll it out like that. Everybody, this is a team effort.
Don't smash anyone's fingers.
I smashed mine. Does that count? This is, it's just too cold, is my problem.
You gotta warm it up.
Warm it up. Come on. Come on, baby. Warm up. Liam's about ready to. Well, what are we doing here?
Do what? I'll warm it up.
Yeah? Alright. Florida!
I'll go so fast that my hands are on fire.
Alright.
And warm.
It's too late now, buddy!
Too late now.
Alright. Go around real close to the edge. And it's a stretchy dough, so that's not gonna cut it. You got a twist.
There we go.
Alright. Why not leave it? Do the next one right here. Get that one as close to the edge as possible and as close to the previous one. Twist it. Twist it. Shake it. Pull it. Bop it. Bop it to start.
Kind of like stuck to the edge. There. I just connected.
It's fine.
Now again, I four times my actual recipe, so I may actually even have too much pierogi dough and have to do something else with it later on. But I promised, I told my sister and my nephew I was going to send some to them. Since we're all stuck away from each other.
We're just going to not take them out when we just cut them.
So I'm going to pull up all my excess.
And I'm going to
wrap it back in my plastic wrap.
Stab it in.
Or just set it on top. The rest of my ball. That's going to be my throwback piece.
Throwback piece.
All right. So we're going to try. Hold on. We're gonna try this gummy bear first. Oh, you already got. I don't know if you're in the shot at all right there. Excuse me. Liam's already got the scoop.
Might want, not want to taste this one.
Boy.
I tried to just swallow.
Absolutely.
That one says absolutely vodka. Yes, it absolutely is. That was pineapple. Gummy bear. It really had a strong. The gummy bear flavor came out really strong.
That's what's so good about vodka. It doesn't cover anything up.
Because it's gross. Did you just take three bears in one shot?
Ooh. I'm just drinking from the cup.
So I have my piece of circle here.
The pieces of
these
circle.
Are very nice and stretchy. The more times you roll out the same stretch of dough, the less pliable it'll be. So we're going to take my cookie scoop.
Grab some.
Now, I'm not sure how much I'm going to be putting in these yet. I got a very small cookie scoop.
Just fold it.
And I don't know if you can see, but it looks like, holy crap, you're never going to get that together. But.
It does.
You stretch it. Pull it around, and I always pinch it in the middle first. And these mashed potatoes are very soft, so a lot of times I'd have people rolling balls out of mashed potatoes to get them ready instead of using the cookie scoop. But I pinched my center, and then I'm going to work my way down and pinch, pinch, pinch. If any of the potatoes come out, you want to wipe those off. You want to try not to get any potatoes in your seam because those ones can pop open. But if you do, you want to pull it out and just pinch, pinch, pinch all the way around and check that out. It's a perfect little pierogi. And what I do is once I get them done, I have all my stuff on the chair next to me. Hold on, Liam. As I line them up very close together in rows on my very old cookie sheets. My mom gave these to me before I was even old enough to move out because she got new ones. So they're 25-year-old, 30-year-old, possibly longer cookie sheets. So I line them all up very close together, freeze them. Once they're frozen, they'll seem like they stick to the tray, but they'll pop, just pry them right up. Then throw them in a Ziploc bag, and then when we're ready to cook them, we toss them in some boiling water, boil just until they float. Then we pull them out with a little straining spoon, set them on a tea towel, just to dry slightly, and then we put them in a skillet with a little butter or margarine. And we actually like to do, we like to do onions and peppers fried with them in the skillet as well. This is the mashed potato one. We actually also do a version with a sweet potato filling. And with the sweet potato filling, when we fry those,
a sweet potato filling,
we actually sprinkle them with, we sprinkle them with cinnamon sugar just as they're finishing up frying and it starts to caramelize a little bit. And those are amazing. I need another scoop, Liam. Let's just line them up. Let's make this quick. And the pinching them close is something that you can really recruit. You know, the youngins to do. Are you a youngin? Well, you didn't stretch that at all.
Yes, I did. Look what I'm doing.
They don't stretch as well, like I said, when you gotten into the multiple batches. I think Brian got a little too warm and had to take his hoodie off.
Yeah.
He had a little too
I'm always
hot.
Cold.
We're under the hot lights here.
68 degrees. It's not pointing to me hot.
I'm freezing right here, but the light isn't pointing at me.
It's kind of pointing at the ceiling.
I'm not pointing. I can see the light in there.
Oh, gosh. Did you see the fancy pronounce?
Lemon juice.
Limon. Limon juice.
I want to try that.
You want to try straight limon juice?
Yeah.
All right.
I think I got that one pretty good.
I think you softened that up pretty dang good with your fingers. All right. With your warm hands. I'm not quite putting the whole scoop. I want a little light because I don't want it to. Liam's beating up the burrito over here. Now, just so you know, I don't want that throwback piece all blended into the big piece.
I'm gonna take that plus some more.
What?
You're gonna take that piece plus some more for the next.
See, that's what you do with cookie dough.
I wanna try lemon juice.
But with the pierogi, I don't like to do that.
I can do the green and
because it's too hard. You have to mix it too much with your hands. Right, let's take this disgusting
tripod.
That's lime.
No, it's lemon. It's lemon.
Okay.
Lemon juice.
Lime juice. Lemon juice.
But just that tiny chunk, I have 11. I'm gonna have 11 pierogies. Come in the center.
Okay.
You should put that in the sink for me. Well, I'm gonna go with this. Wait, were any of the gummy bears lemon? I'm gonna go with a lemon gummy bear.
So it tastes the same.
Is that pineapple? I don't know.
Pineapple. What?
It's so sour.
I can't eat the gummy. I want a green one.
It's actually pretty good. I like it.
Oh, you can have the last one then.
Mmm.
What is wrong with you people? He's like,
I don't know. I just like it.
Oh, it's very sour.
I like it a lot. The original since 1910.
Yeah, the lemon comes through a lot.
Yeah.
But it's not overpowering.
It says you.
Because there's a sweetness to it.
Yeah.
It's kind of like really strong lemonade. Peach schnapping turtle.
Schnapping turtle.
It says hello.
There's a picture of a turtle. It's a peach schnapping turtle.
Strong.
Schnapps.
Schnapping.
Schnapping turtle.
Schnapping. He schnapped.
Oh, Leo.
Schnapp.
Why are you here?
Because I told him to get in the center.
Lemon juice.
Lemon.
Okay, but you a lot of these are not for you.
Oh no!
I know.
My bowl fell out.
I dislike sand.
Okay, and by the way, with the gummy bears, we, it is probably, it's after 10, it's probably close to 10:30. We put them all in, yesterday afternoon, late afternoon, was when we put them in there, so they've only been soaking for a little over 24 hours.
Yeah.
2 days!
20.
They've been 27. In there for 2 dang days!
26, 27, somewhere like that.
And, we didn't put them in the refrigerator.
Yeah. Gigi's just sleeping. Why is there flour?
I made the mistake of picking up Chi-Chi right after his dust bath earlier. I was so itchy. It got all over my nose.
What's peach snapping?
Peachy.
Peach. Whew. Not god-awful, but very strong. I'd say of the alcohols, it was the best one so far.
Not bad.
That good?
Huh?
Not bad.
You ripped it, so no, that's not. That's not good. I just. Okay, I wanted to get Wesley, who wants to make a pierogi. I told Brian, I asked him to turn the camera back on, but he wasn't paying attention to me. And I still has. I'm waiting to turn the camera back on!
Peeps.
So Liam had to yell at me and say, stop yelling at Deb! We're gonna call the police!
Peeps.
Liam. Alright. Did you just take a piece of my dough? So, this rolled out a lot easier already. I'm just gonna cut out two to show Wesley. Liam's waiting to try the orange flavor, the orange juice. All right. There's gonna be a small little scoop. Let me put less in yours just so it's easier for you, okay? Oops, a couple less than mine, too. All right. So, what you want to do, pick up your pierogi, Wesley. Using the sides of your thumbs like this.
I can't pick it up.
Pick it up. Use the sides of your thumbs and pull. Just stretch it. Pull the dough. Stretch harder. Harder, 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 harder. Good job. Now pull it up to the center and pinch the pieces of dough together at the top. Pinch. All right, good. Now without trying to squeeze out the mashed potatoes, you can even stretch it a little. You want to pinch down the sides. I knew I had a hole in it when I started, but I was going to go with it anyways. I'm going to create a patch on this one. It's nice and sticky, so I should be able to do it. Let me see. What? I think I got a new pierogi helper. Liam says he's... Oh, Liam's jealous. Do you know the one problem with making all these pierogies, Brian?
What's that?
Because we have zero freezer space.
Oh, that's...
And these all have to be frozen flat on trays. I'm going to try a green one. Kind of wish there was an orange one in here. That orange juice isn't great. Orange juice.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
They're like little containers. Little cardboard containers of orange juice.
Styrofoam, excuse me.
It's school orange juice.
Well, no, it's in styrofoam now. What are we trying next over there, Brian?
Midori melon liquor smells gross.
That's what the label says. On the styrofoam.
It's not good, if you've ever had it, it's
it's a little bit gross.
It's pretty old. I never use it because it's not good.
It's quite old.
I've seen some good drinks that are supposed to be good that have it in it, so I mean, I have hope for it someday, if I have the right ingredients.
Someday when you knock up on a star. I'm looking at all these caramelized onions in here. I'm gonna heat up some of these mashed potatoes.
See them on the floor.
Oh, my scooper fell in. I'm not used to having to move everything every time I want to do something. All right. First taste is not bad. It's not that bad.
No, it's not. I don't know what happened.
It's way better than some of the other ones.
It's like the gummy bears didn't soak it up?
No, they got big.
Okay, they did.
I think the gummy bears made it taste better. How many more cups we got in there? Too many.
9 or so.
The balls keep rolling away.
Don't want that.
I'm gonna make Brian help when we're done trying all the flavors.
Amaretto sour.
Oh gosh, is that what's gonna happen at the end here?
What else we got here? I had some fruit punch.
Oh, I didn't even like that fruit punch by itself. I got a headache.
Doesn't look very good, but...
How drunk are these gummy bears?
It's actually pretty good.
I'll try the,
I didn't expect it to be good. Okay.
You didn't mix the triple sec in with, did you? No. Oh, it's not bad. Oh! Yeah, it's kind of good. What is it?
Fruit punch, lemon, and amaretto. It's an amaretto.
So lemon and amaretto.
It's basically.
Yeah, I kind of like it. What?
I've been learning about bar stuff.
I almost thought about getting you bartending lessons for your birthday.
I know, we've talked about it.
It's hard to find time for that kind of stuff.
Sublime. Sublime.
I hope it's sublime and not sublug gross. Subla too sour. Now.
Falling apart.
Neither one. Okay, so I'm trying to decide between what I want to veto to get to have to try. And we have.
That's not bad at all.
We have yet to come across either one. Can you tell? Do you know which ones I don't want to try?
I know which ones you don't want to try.
You know which, both of them?
Yeah, I do.
Which ones?
The one you call Gaggermeister. Just Jägermeister. And, of course, soy sauce.
What? Oh, my God. You know me way too well. Oh, that one fell apart. And, that's crazy that you could guess.
You've been married 10 years. Ah, you're gonna lose it again.
Get, sucker, get up here. I got two heads.
And you lost one.
Ah! That was way worse than the lemon juice. Not bad, my ass. That was terrible.
I need another one.
Go right ahead.
It's pretty good.
I'd rather have another shot of the tequila one. I'm not asking.
He's got some rum.
Rumster.
White rum. I would not recommend you let this one sit around in your mouth.
Ugh.
Because rum is not well liked in these parts. I know, like,
in these here parts.
Pirates like it.
Arr, matey! Speak for yourself, matey!
Well, the pirates will love that one. We'll get to that one later.
Just full of my pierogies.
Hi, Rumster.
Oh man. Pa-rum-bum-bum-bum.
Thinking about your puns?
I am. Coming up with more clever ones now. I'm making very small portions at a time while we're doing this. I used to make giant batches and had a couple of my friends over and we just have an assembly line.
It's not that bad.
Somebody rolling balls, somebody stuffing them, somebody cutting them out. It's always great to have baking nights with your friends and stock up on all your freezer stuff. And everybody helps with everything. For a minute there, I just saw M-S-T-E-R and thought it said hamster.
Munster.
Hamster. You thought you said it wasn't so bad. And why do I want to get rid of it quick? Here.
So you don't throw up.
Here, you do this one. I'll just take the...
I already had one.
I'll drink the whole rest. So I don't have to taste it. I'll just swallow the bears.
I don't know if you can.
I swallowed them in the tequila. And something else, didn't I? Oh. That tasted like rubbing alcohol. What?
Yeah.
Rubbing alcohol.
It's pretty bad.
I'm glad I'm not the only one with the weird looks.
So I said it's not that bad after looking at the camera.
Were you pretty disappointed I made you eat another one? I couldn't swallow 3 gummy bears. Now, we're going to mix this lime juice eventually with some, like, snapping turtle. The sublime with the snapping turtle and the orange juice. Oh, wait, the orange juice already had some.
Wait, we didn't drink the rest of this.
Huh?
We didn't drink the rest of this.
That wasn't what you mixed, was it?
Yeah, it was.
Then what's this? Is that just orange? Oh.
Yeah.
Well, let's mix the orange, the peach, and the lime. And then we'll throw in a little of something gross and strong.
What's that? Someone say lime?
Does somebody say, oh God, no! This red wine, we decided to try box wine. We thought Brian did research and found out he thought red wine would be best. Then we mistakenly got a box of red and a box of white somehow. The white.
Moscato.
Yes, the
Moscato.
Moscato was pretty dang good.
Merlot.
The Merlot was pretty damn awful to begin with, and then we didn't want to drink it, so we sat in there for too long, and then we tried to drink it, and it was gosh awful terrible.
Tastes like vinegar.
Yeah, it was. And this is what we used. That's what's in there.
That's what we had.
This horrible. I might even want to change my veto from Jägermeister to this disgusting wine.
Give it a smell. It's not that strong.
If I whack it and spill it away, why does a gummy bear look weird?
It just looks.
It looks weird, Brian.
He's tanned. He's got a good tan. Some spots.
That's what I meant. He's got spots all over him. He's a diseased bear.
Oh. What is that? No, you got.
No, I can't do it. I cannot do that one.
It's probably not good for us.
The smell of it makes me want. Take a deep whiff. Just breathe it in and try not to get a gaggy face. No, I can't.
It's probably not good for us. Okay, okay. We'll skip it.
And this is why I married him.
Okay.
Oh, pickle. There's so many I don't want to try.
This is pickle juice.
I know.
I don't like pickles. I don't hate them, but I don't like them.
Well, I don't know where Liam definitely did not get it from. Eat my pickle juice. I'm gonna need some more water. There was a lot of pickle juice. Oh, that's right. You spilled it on the floor when we poured it in here. Make a pickle pierogi.
It's subtle, but it's not good.
Should we put...
I don't like pickles, though, so I don't know.
Should we make a gummy bear pierogi and boil it and fry it up? I feel like we should.
It'll just melt. We've seen that.
But
in coffee, it just melted.
I feel like for this video, we should make a gummy bear pierogi.
All right.
Let's shoot.
Throw them in there.
Oh no, that is gross.
It's subtle.
It's not subtle. I just.
Ugh.
Lisa? I'd like some more. How many times is that? Please, sir! Okay, I got 2, 4, 6 gummy bears stuffed in my pierogi dough. And I gotta make sure this one doesn't split open. And Brian put the itty bitty tiny little pan on a big giant.
All right.
on a big giant burner just now.
It's the same. It heats it better.
I know it does heat it better, but you're also heating up the handle. I burnt myself on one like that the other day.
I grew it back so it doesn't.
Oh, all right. This is good over here to keep it separate. I have to say, I did not like the pickle juice.
I don't think anyone did.
But I tried it. What else?
Yes.
Lots.
Is disconcerting.
Why? Oh, shoot.
This is 151 rum. You can't even buy it anymore.
It's 151-867-5309-EIN.
But,
I feel like I'm burning.
Look.
What the flippity gibbets? Show the camera a little closer what came about with the 151.
I can't really see it. Yeah.
It's hard to show on the camera, but
that was another time I made you get up.
they've bleached a bit.
I'll tell you what, I'm more apt to try that than I am the wine, though.
I don't know if we can.
Okay, just try half.
It's like, they're hard.
They're hard?
They're rubbery. They've gotten so weird.
Oh, they are. They absorbed almost all the liquid, period. It looks like a tooth.
It does look like a molar.
It's very hard. It's burning my lips. I can't hardly bite into it. What? Look! You can't see it. It's terrible. But the whole inside is still yellow. It's like it encased the gummy bear. Like, I feel like if we... Ooh! Where'd it... Stop slipping and slapping off my... You see it?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like you can almost cut off and have a perfectly intact gummy bear in there. Not even any more of that. You gonna take a nibble there? Nibble it.
Well, I can't let you be the only
one. And I'm the only one who's gonna try the gross gummy bears. Look at the bottom of the green one.
Wow, it's potent.
Yeah. We are not adding that to our sublime juice.
That 151 is just too strong. That's why they got rid of it. Because people were stupid.
What?
I don't know what this says.
Seagram's Wild Berry! Seagram. The letter C.
Seagram.
And the and the word wild is obviously written wildly.
Oh, it's Seagram's.
I feel like this one's gonna be good.
Yeah.
Ooh, that sucker is big!
Jeez.
I think that's the biggest one yet!
He's been bathing for a long time.
Holy butt. Okay, get out of gummy bear. Let's oh no, he's falling apart. Like, I want to do a size comparison, but there's get ready, quick. It's a monster.
It's like six times.
Yeah, that was good.
Not bad at all.
Drink?
I got this one. Apple ale. Red's apple ale.
Oh no!
that you said was gross.
I don't want to try that one. This one's like beer.
Yeah.
I hate beer.
I don't like beer, but I won't turn it away. I don't even taste the beer. Okay, slightly on the end.
Which means I'll taste it a lot.
I don't think you will. You've said that you're a super taster.
Super taster. So I feel like I am. Wait, what's that? Oh, I did not like that brand. It's gross. Moving on.
It's not bad. It's perfectly okay.
Did you eat two of them?
No, yeah, I did.
Okay, well, this one broke, so I'm just gonna eat his butt. Okay, I'm just gonna eat his midsection.
See? It's gone.
Alright, it's definitely not as bad as I
come on.
Thought at all.
Yeah.
Is my water boiling, Brian?
Yeah, it is.
Alright, put them on in there. We're not gonna fry them afterward, right?
No.
Fry them in some peppers and onions.
Oh, you want that boiling and melting the gummy bears.
The re-roll actually works better the longer you let it sit in the plastic instead of trying to do it right away. Whew! I just get this.
Not as good.
Really?
That one's still good.
The lime. It's got a gross flavor.
Lime goes in drinks.
I also hate key lime pie.
Hate it.
I do not like key lime pie. Well, the ones I tried them. I had it at the grocery store bakery that I worked at.
I had it in our food class.
We had key lime pie in our food.
Yeah, I think they call it key lime cheesecake. Same thing, right?
No, but I'm sure it has similar flavor.
But yeah, it was like a kind of like a, you know what? A place I worked, I had it too. It was also key lime cheesecake. It was Mr. Hero.
I don't like.
And look it up. It's a local restaurant.
It's a hero.
It's there for 11 years. 11 years of fast food.
Long, long time. It was your first job, though, right?
Yeah, it was. I was still in high school when I started.
So that means you went from there to there. You've only had 4 jobs ever. He's only had four.
Not mentioning where I am now. Yes.
Well, yeah, because you went through different positions. That doesn't count.
Well,
but you've only worked
in the company.
Well, yeah, I'm not mentioning any of the other ones.
But yeah.
You've only worked for 4 places.
Yeah.
I've worked for many places. Not a great many. I did. I'm the queen of 3 years. I tend to work at places for 3 years. I mean,
except
obviously.
Your current place.
Yes, I'm working in my going through towards my 10 now.
I'm just about a 10 where I am.
And yeah, you'll hit 10 before me. And then I used to always also,
December.
Huh?
In December.
Yeah, and then mine will be a couple months later. I was the queen of, when I was single and had no children, of second jobs. If I count, I'd be like, why can't I work until 1 a.m. at one job and then be back at work at 5 a.m. the next day at the next job? And then when I was doing that, the one place actually shut down. They shut down the whole company. And I'll tell you, it was probably the best thing for me because I actually really liked who I worked with and stuff, and it was killing me. And then I got myself roped into like 20-hour shifts working in a bakery and a donut shop and at one of my other places that I was working at the time. I tend to get in over my head.
No kidding.
Over my head. Is that still boiling? Or I think it's probably done. It only needs to boil till... It only needs to boil till you drop a ball on the table. Balls in your court, Brian! Let's see how many times I can have him get up. Over and over and over again. I actually don't have one. I don't know what I was thinking. I got all of my cookie sheets out. I don't even have one full yet. Was it floating?
Hard to say. It wasn't much water in
it. Now the kids, they always say, I don't like pierogies. They don't like store-bought pierogies. And the funny thing is, Wesley hates mashed potatoes, too. But he'll eat all your pierogies. Some of the pink leached out. Let it cool.
Bleeding. No gag.
On the vomit sauce.
It's soy sauce.
I think I would rather have Jägermeister than soy sauce.
You just take a nibble.
What? Take a nibble, that's gonna be the only thing. I don't like the look on your face.
Just tastes like soy sauce. But I don't care. I don't care for, like, it doesn't, I'm okay with soy sauce. You're not.
No, I do not.
I think the worst thing is the smell. It smells like a barnyard animal.
That's encouraging.
Want to smell the cup?
Oh! No. Not even gonna nibble it.
I mean, I feel like I could eat a whole gummy bear, which it's not really, it didn't absorb that much. I mean, there's a lot of salt in here.
Yeah, they're actually not much bigger than when they started.
So maybe...
I mean, they're no Seagrams.
Yeah. No Seagrams. The worst part is the smell. The taste is mild, I think. But I've said that about other things, and you said no. It's the last one.
I got 32 on that tray, it looks like. Approximately. Is that the last one? Why'd we say the very grossest two for last? Did you do that on purpose?
No. It was just kind of random.
Mm-hmm. And I did actually label this one Jägermeister.
Jägermeister. It's the actual name brand.
I just white mashed potatoes on my shirt.
It's not like menthol, Chuck's menthol, not menthol, whatever they call it. I'm not sure. I can't think of the name right now.
I have no idea what you're talking about. a servings of pierogies, I'd say 6 makes a decent serving. If you're not having many, like, really sides with it, I'd say you can eat 8. I usually give what? How many do I give the kids? 3 or 4?
Yeah, something like that. At least 4.
But don't you think 6 is a good serving size if you're not having, or unless you're, if you're having sides, if you're not having sides, 8?
Yeah, if no sides, 8. That's what we usually do for us. This size. They're not mini.
Yeah, they're
pierogies.
They're a good size pierogi. That one looked really pretty. Did you see how pretty that one looks? I'm gonna flute it out. Check it out. Look how nice that looks. I feel like I should just not wait for your opinion. I should not have been waiting for you to taste them first.
And get your... at the same time. This one, I don't know. It seems like the gummy bears absorb, like, all the alcohol into them, and then they start absorbing the taste. As it tastes, they, almost all of them taste like rubbing alcohol. I don't know why, man. They're just gummy bears. You don't have to try it if you want to kill us.
We didn't do the other one, so I have to at least nibble it. It tastes like, it smells like black licorice. It's always
a little more potent than that.
I do not like the taste of Jaeger.
I like a Jaeger bomb.
I had a bad experience with Jaeger. It made me super sick. The one time ever I've thrown up from alcohol, I had been drinking Jaeger.
Among other things.
Oh yeah, I was drinking.
You finished all the other stuff.
Huh?
You finished all the other stuff, right?
I drank, we had wine coolers and some flavor of pucker. I was with my friend and her boyfriend in Canada.
Probably had alcohol poisoning.
And they closed there was a huge power outage across big chunk of
the
Canada.
Big power outage.
And like New York, a whole chunk of the United States. And they closed the borders. So we couldn't come home. We were like on the top floor of the hotel. And the elevators were out. And we didn't even know what happened because we were on a boat, little boat tour at the time. So we walked around and found...
Didn't notice all the lights go out.
Well, when we were walking, because we were out on a boat. So there was no light that would have gone out at the time. And then on our way back to the hotel, all the traffic lights were out. We're like, what's going on? So we found a liquor store that took cash. And... got a bunch of alcohol and tried to play cards in the dark, and I was throwing that. It made me sick, very sick. All right, gummy bear pierogi. I mean, I'm sure it's not gonna be disgusting. Woo!
What is going on there?
It turned into a gummy bear syrup. Look at that. Ooh. I'm gonna squeeze that jello bear out. I won't take a bite at the end. I'll take a bite more of the center so I can. Okay. I feel like it's gonna stick to my teeth though. Wait. I got some grocer on there. I got a Jaeger bear.
Would you like to use this one?
Yeah. There's a chunk of Jaeger Bear on the table. Whoa. Okay, you can't see this, I'm sure, but it's glistening in the light as it slowly streams down.
Tastes like nothing.
Which has them? A gummy bear. The pierogi. The pierogi's a little chewy. So it all kind of fits together, actually.
It's kind of like a turnover.
Maybe a little. Is there anything else we can make into a pierogi? You got the kids' Easter baskets right there. Marshmallow egg pierogi.
Sour cream and chives, chips pierogi.
I'd say that.
It'd probably get too wet inside.
Yeah, it'd be too mushy. Brian's checking the cabinets. Peanut butter pierogi?
Marshmallow?
Well, I said one of these chocolate marshmallow eggs. But we just stick a whole marshmallow. There's an open one on the bottom. Right in the front of the cabinet. From when we made s'mores over the fire a couple weeks ago. Our kids love to have stuff over the fire outside.
I like a skinny kid.
We used to make, have a fire at my grandma's house. In the fireplace to cook hot dogs. I hate hot dogs.
I don't think anyone loves them.
Marshmallow pierogi. Are we just doing marshmallow or are we going to do some other weird?
We'll just do marshmallow for now.
Brian, put the water back on the boil. Now, when you heat a marshmallow in the microwave or in the oven, it expands. So what do we think it's gonna do inside this here pierogi? All right, so what do you think was the worst flavor?
Well, the alcohol all tasted like rubbing alcohol.
Except the
Unfortunately.
Except the sea grams.
Well, there's so little alcohol.
It's true.
The red apple, that red's apple ale.
There's probably very little alcohol in that as well.
Yeah. One of them was 9%.
Peach schnapps wasn't bad. I think out of all the actual liqueur, the peach schnapps was the one that wasn't the worst. Or it was the better of them.
It was not the worst.
Yes, Liam, we made a gummy bear pierogi.
Is that it?
No, it's right there on the plate. We cooked it.
Oh, I don't think... What the... I think it dried over time. Yikes! Don't eat that!
This plate might be difficult to clean.
Yeah. And difficult to cut. Oh, kind of gummy bear.
Well, there's a bunch of different ones. Doesn't matter. Mm. Not terrible, right?
Not terrible.
You see my cutting mat? We used to keep these in the under the oven. And then inside the drawer from the oven. It got shoved up inside the oven while it was on and melted. Now, should we pour some chocolate over that?
No. Ruin it.
Pour some graham cracker crumb? It's a smorogie.
It's, it's pliable.
Is the marshmallow actually melted? Oh, yeah.
Maybe we should do this on camera. Probably can't see behind all of our cups.
It's true. Like I'm getting lazy and my dough's getting thicker.
Isn't that what happens when you get a lot of stuff?
Yeah, pretty much. Look at it ooze out. I mean, it looks good. I'll eat it. It's not bad.
No. But it tastes confused.
Yeah, I felt like
the dough, it kind of like
definitely get your two mouth separate says, tastes.
Okay. Right, and savory, and then you get to the marshmallow. It's like, wait, what?
Yeah, with the gummy bears, I felt like the gummy bear, the sugar leached into the dough, and there wasn't that dough flavor.
Yeah. I like the dough flavor.
I do too.
I'm not a sugar kind of person. I would rather have savory than the sweet.
Except when it comes to certain things. Chocolate chip cookies.
Well, okay. Everyone has their dessert. But given them the choice between like McDonald's fries or chocolate chip cookies. Take the McDonald's fries.
Really?
Yeah.
What about Ding Dong Cake?
And?
McDonald's fries.
Ding Dong Cake.
Ding Dong Cake's pretty good?
It is.
Guess what you're getting for your
birthday? That's one of our videos. Yeah.
What about chocolate cream pie? Or a burger.
Chocolate cream pie? If it's a good burger, probably the burger.
What about Ding Dong Cake or the Burn and Love Burger from Red Robin?
Burger.
Really?
If we were at Red Robin, yeah.
What if we had to get it to go? Like tonight.
It wasn't so good to go.
Neither were the fries.
Alright, well, that's it for tonight then. Just gonna keep working.
Keep working away on my pierogies.